For the attention of Stacey Dooley, brackets urgent. Hello, Poppet. Sorry I can't make the charity car wash. She loves a foamy chamois. But I'm roving as the host of Travel Man.
Each week I'll whisk away a brand new best friend and treat them to the best 48 hours of their lives.
This week I'm in Dublin with a very funny, hilarious Mawan Rizwan.
I'm being sabotaged.
Over an unforgettable 48 hours, we'll hear from the other side.
James, what are you saying?
James?
I feel a ton better since I landed in dear, dirty Dublin.
Thrill to the chill.
I sound more vulnerable than I am.
And pour to perfection.
This is the slowest bar in the world.
Oh, look.
Merry Christmas, everyone.
See you soon. Sopa Mazda for me. Love, Joe Lycett. You ready, Mawan?
Sorry, just WhatsApping Stacey Dooley.
Well, this is going to our agent. Let's have us some Dublin.
So out of all the hot places in the world, you've brought me to Dublin.
It's a fabulous city. And you know, it means Blackpool in old Irish Celtic.
Really?
But of course, they'd never call the place Blackpool.
No.
So they called it Dublin.
I wish they called it Ibiza.
Dublin has the highest ratio of visitors to locals in the world. It welcomes all comers, just like your mum. We're checking into one of its newest hotels, the Mason.
This is where we live now.
Ooh, bougie, baby. Do you like how I've packed light for 48 hours? I've only got the one outfit.
Oh, hello there.
Hi, welcome to the Mason.
Thank you very
much.
How are
you today?
I'm very well. I'm here with my stylist, and we'd like to check in, please.
The hotel is formed from a 19th century townhouse and warehouse on the bank of the River Liffey. Mawan's in the townhouse side.
Bathtub?
Well, I'm keeping house in the warehouse penthouse.
Is that a hot tub? Oh, my word. Oh, and a living room as well. And a fridge! Oh, my God, I love fridges!
There's a steakhouse, bar, coffee shop, gym, pool, and my new must-have, a barbershop.
Hey, Joe.
Mm-hmm.
The plastic surgery went well, eh?
Imagine he just pulls this off and I look like Sandy Tuxford.
Am I still me?
Thank you, Channel 4.
Exfoliated and depilated.
Gorgeous.
We head out to explore Dublin. What comes first? Drink? Girls? Public art?
Mawan, please tell me you love statues.
Oh, man, I thought you'd never ask.
Because there's 275 in Dublin, and we're going to see each one.
Great, how delicious. Do you know things about these statues?
What I do know is that there's a QR code, and I can scan it with my mobile device.
Give me that statue education, baby.
OK, hang on.
The meeting place is one of 12 statues who've been given a voice by Irish writers and actors.
Oh, look, they're calling us. How fun is that?
Hello, ladies.
Hello.
Hello there.
Oh, hello.
Well, hello. We're up for the day to do a bit of shopping.
Is this live?
Our new bronze friends bang on incessantly about how their shopping bags were once stolen.
Oh, that was dreadful.
Can't believe they've made statues even more fun.
Mind yourself now.
So is this the holiday, then?
Is this... this is it.
Vibing off Mawan's positive mindset, we cross the River Liffey via the not unexpected method of a bridge in search of the original gay icon.
Oh, look!
Ah!
It's Sue Perkins.
Oh, yeah.
Behold me here, Oscar Fingal O'Flaherty Wills Wilde.
Dublin-born and educated, Oscar Wilde knocked out novels, plays and zingers galore before falling foul of Victorian values.
One of the most quoted people in the world, famous for his quotes such as garlic bread. That's one of his.
Do you have an Ector card?
Yeah, that was one of his.
Anyone remember Wagon Wheels?
It is quite fabulous, this statue.
Yeah.
Off to Temple Bar, the city's cultural and stag night quarter, like the legends we are.
You've been there before on a stag do?
Yeah, I'm always on stag do.
Yeah, you
I'm
are.
On one right now.
Yeah.
To our final statue, the fictional poster girl for Dublin, mobile mollusk merchant Molly Malone.
You miss little things while on a plinth.
I can still tell you with certainty where to find the best seafood in Dublin.
What's your visceral feeling to this? What's your...
Ain't no shame, ladies, do your thing. Just make sure you're ahead of the game. That's what I'm getting. What about you?
Weirdly, exactly the same.
Yeah. Funny, isn't it?
Yeah. Have you noticed what's going on with the particularly shiny area of her anatomy?
Is that because people keep rubbing it?
Yeah, apparently it brings you good luck.
Yeah, so does the patriarchy.
Before the roaming charges bankrupt us...
Should we get some lunch?
We head in search of food at one of Dublin's most exclusive lunching spots.
Shall we?
Yeah, you're gonna have to treat a girl.
Exclusive because Assassination Custard seats 8 at a squeeze.
Hi.
Hello.
Hi.
Since 2015, wife and husband team of Gwen and Ken have been cooking up multi-course lunches in this former sandwich shop.
How's it going?
That's good. How are you?
All right, you well?
Yeah,
good.
Very well.
You're here for the duration, yeah? The whole menu? Yeah?
Why not?
We'll get it all. We'll get one of everything.
Great.
The whole lot, please. I've not read it.
The ever-changing menu is presented on a paper bag and begins with homemade vermouth.
Cheers.
Cheers, man. To Dublin.
To Dublin.
To ordering everything on the menu. Mm.
You've never done that before?
No.
Oh, my God. You should try it in Mackie D's.
Oh, that's good.
Oh, that is lovely. Mm-hmm.
These are sort of pork lard biscuits, and then that's our piccalilli as well.
Oh, pork.
These are Padron peppers.
That's really nice.
Duck fat toast and sauerkraut.
A lot of fat. It squirted out of the bread.
Oh!
Are you into that?
What do you think I look like this?
This is a caponata. It's a sweet and sour deep-fried veg and partridge.
They're the ones that make the really loud noises when you go to countryside, isn't it?
I've never heard it alive.
What do they sound like, Dad? So delicious.
That's really nice.
They're ray cheeks, or the jowls. They call them ray jowls in Dublin.
Oh, my God.
It's like cod.
If it was really soft.
And better than cod.
A bit cheeky.
It's like a cheeky cod. It's a real mix of stuff here, isn't it?
Yeah, we've been to all the continents.
What have we had? We've had Padron peppers. What continent's that?
Brazil.
Yes, the continent of Brazil. We had the drink.
Ibiza.
The continent of Ibiza.
Yeah.
Duck fat bread.
Loughborough.
The continent of Loughborough.
Uh-huh. Hey, Joe, I'm feeling a bit tipsy.
Let's have a dessert.
Let's have a dessert. Yes!
Egg white with coriander seed and cocoa.
There's so much going on in
there. Oh, my God. I'm getting mint.
I don't think there's any mint in there.
I'm getting cardamom.
Is there mint or cardamom in this?
No.
I'm definitely getting coffee.
Is there coffee in it? Mawan.
Yeah.
How would you sum up the experience of Assassination Custard?
Relentless. How would you describe it?
I thought it was brilliant. Shall we go?
Yes.
Thank you both so much for having us. Just put it on the tab in the name of Jimmy Carr.
After a quick nap, it's a simple segue from Dublin's smallest restaurant to its biggest tourist attraction.
Oh, I was hoping you'd bring me here.
Guess how many pints are drunk worldwide every day?
How many?
10 million!
10 million? You're joking.
I wouldn't joke ever.
You're a fact machine.
Despite the fact that other stouts are widely available, this place attracted 1.7 million visitors in 2019, who were no doubt as thrilled as we were to learn that this stout is made of barley, hops, yeast, and...
water!
Wow! I love it.
The entire storehouse is based on the shape of a pint glass and also the shape of a building, because otherwise it would just fall down.
Oh, this has changed my life, Joe.
I don't think it's changing my life. I'm just desperate for a pint now.
Upstairs, the learning gets interactive as we enter the white room.
Are we in heaven?
Here, Guide Colm leads us through the 4 key scents that make up the bouquet of this particular beer.
Each one represents a different ingredient.
I thought you were just obsessed with vaping.
Between 80 to 90% of your taste is produced by smell. I can't be more exact. I'm not Stephen Fry.
Mm. I like this one.
Hey, man, love this vibe, man.
Oh, he's gone straight to his head. Such a lightweight on malt.
All this information is fascinating, and in no way a slog. You just have to get through before the free pint.
Finally!
We would like 2 WKDs, please.
I'm going to show you how to pour the perfect pint.
Yeah, I've got a bit of PTSD about this, because I had one shift in a pub in Birmingham, and I couldn't do it. In fact, they still owe me the money for that shift. Mm. It's the Junction in Moseley, and you owe me cash.
Ready to nurse a perfect pint, as well as some long-held grievances, we follow Colm's instructions carefully.
That felt really nice.
Feels good, doesn't it?
Oh.
Yeah, absolutely. So we're going to let that settle. This is called the surge.
The painstaking wait for inebriation is due to this particular brand of beer being pressurised with nitrogen, whose tiny bubbles need time to sort themselves out.
Look at that dome.
Wow, Mawan.
Come at me, nitrogen.
Wow. Sensational.
Oh, my God, I'm an expert.
Yeah. Outstanding. Outstanding.
You're like a gay Asian Pat Butcher.
Has been said.
Time for Colm to very mildly blow our minds.
We're actually going to put your face on that head.
In what may be the single most pointless invention since the Amstrad emailer. Hi, Alan. We can now print our own faces onto our pints.
Look, I'm on a pint.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, that's so nice.
My mom's going to be so proud of me for this haram act.
Seeing us for the winos we are, Colm sensibly dumps us in the bar.
Mm-hmm. I tell you what, my face,
yeah,
is delicious.
My face is even more delicious.
Mm. I'm smooth, I'm a bit bitter, creamy.
I'm tall, dark and handsome.
Yeah.
Joe, is this the end?
Of your life?
Of the trip?
Well, it's the end of part one.
But where there's a part one, there's a part two, where we'll be invigorated.
I think I've got into shock.
Educated.
Come at me, education.
And vocally emasculated.
Have a lovely day.
In Dublin's fair city, where Mawan Rizwan and I, Joe Lycett, are so pretty, you rejoin us as we head for a bracing morning dip at 40 Foot, a spot immortalised by top Irish novel-writing lad James Joyce in his chick-lit classic, Ulysses. Haven't read it. There's probably a movie.
Oh, this looks nice, doesn't it?
I feel a bit dramatic in these, though.
Dramatic?
Yeah, look at those people just getting in naked because they're creatures of the earth.
Yes, but we're celebrities.
In the book, Joyce calls the sea here snot green. And more alarmingly, scrotum tightening.
Well, how does this make you feel?
Cold.
Yeah.
But I'll do it. My partner gave me really good advice.
Yeah.
He said, don't think about the cold, think about the sensation.
Which is cold.
Cold, yes. Yeah. But just zone in on, oh, that's tingly.
During the pandemic, the world went wild swimming crazy, with various lunatics saying it boosts immunity, improves circulation, and even lifts the libido. We bare our flesh for the shortest possible swim our contracts will allow.
Go for it.
You're just going in, I'm just going in.
Yes!
Are you feeling warmer?
Yeah.
That's me, Korean.
My scrotum has very much gone inside.
I'm ready to leave now!
To be honest, it just reminds me of when some Villa fans threw me into the canal.
I'm just so impressed with all these people just getting in, just being really chill about it.
Look at her. She's got her sunglasses on. The sun is not out, mate.
No.
Like, sunshine is a state of mind, I guess. I think that's the coldest sea I've ever been in. I sound more vulnerable than I am.
Yeah.
This is too much nature. I hate you, man.
Having invigorated the body, it is time to give the mind a nudge at Ireland's most famous seat of learning.
Did you go to university?
Nope, but I'm going right now.
Trinity College is Dublin's answer to the University of Wolverhampton and home to one of the world's most amazing libraries, the Long Room.
Oh.
O-M-G.
Oh my, this is nuts.
Literally, a literary must-see.
This is like an old water stones.
Just being here makes me feel cleverer. Oh, what's this?
Oh, look, the Book of Calice. It's got the four testaments in.
Oh, so it's biblical, yeah?
Biblical stuff.
What's it say? My milkshake
bringeth
all the lads to thine yard, and they're like
better than
doth.
No, wait, so why is this important?
It's the oldest book in Ireland, Mawan. It's a fantastic read.
Is it?
I don't know. Nobody knows because you can't touch it.
Yeah. It's a real page turner. Oh, wait, can't turn the pages. Mm.
We tried to take the Book of Kells home, but are told my Kingsheath library card is not valid. So leave in a huff and go in search of an attraction more in tune with our demographic.
Have you ever heard of a thing called music?
No.
Well, this is where they make it.
All of it?
All of it.
Ireland is famous for great music and U2. Opened in 1978, Windmill Lane Studios is the country's Abbey Road.
So, welcome to the world-famous Windmill Lane Recording Studio. My name's Maria, and I will be your tour guide.
Since 2020, the studio has run tours, lifting the lid on the recording process.
We had the Rolling Stones recording their Voodoo Lounge. Charlie Watts, the drummer, decided to ask the engineers to mic up the drum kit here because it had the biggest reverb sound.
Yep, that works.
The Gallery of Stars here as we make our way up to Studio One. Great icons here from the Rolling Stones, Def Leppard, wow. U2 Boy.
Never heard of them.
Pop, Gavin Kylie!
Kylie!
Kylie! So welcome to the control room.
Oh, the starship.
Of Studio One.
Wow.
And this is Keane, our engineer. He makes all the sound really happen in here. This desk here is a Neve VR Legend. It is a legend desk, one of the kind.
While they're talking, I'm mainly thinking that I could be resting my bottom where Kylie once rested hers.
So we're going to take you into the live room of Studio One.
What?
We've set up two mics, and we thought
we'd like to
do a little bit of singing and to experience what
yes.
it feels like.
Visitors taking the more expensive Artist Pass tour can even release their inner diva and record a track.
Oh, I can hear like an echo on my voice. I'm trapped in a well!
Hello, hello, baby.
Am I going first?
You go first. You do the first line.
Okay.
Hello, hello, baby. You called. I can't hear a thing.
I have no service in the club, you say, say.
What did you say? Oh, you're breaking up on me.
Sorry, I cannot hear you. I'm kind of...
Lady Gaga is another in the long list of artists who've made great music at Windmill Lane. A list that now includes us.
Falling, I don't want to think anymore. I left my head and my heart on the dance floor.
But sadly, due to the cost of licensing music, that's as much of this banger as we can afford to show you.
Number one, baby!
That's been recorded, has it?
Yes, of course it has been recorded.
Could you delete that recording and never speak to anyone about it again?
We just got one take, that's a bit unfair. I feel like you two would do more than one take.
We've got time for one more attraction, and it's one that's sure to delight any fans of wax museums.
Go on, can I ask you a question?
Yeah.
Do you like wax?
Light me a candle.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Well, you're going to love the National Wax Museum.
Opened in 1987, Ireland's most popular and only waxwork museum is home to several dozen effigies of the country's most famous daughters and sons, all reached through a hall of mirrors.
Oh my, no.
I can see so many Moans.
Is that the real you? Is that the mirror you?
I don't know.
Whoa.
I tell you what, my trousers look fantastic though, don't they?
Okay, the camera guy's there. He's definitely in front of us, so I'm just gonna run towards him.
Yeah.
Yeah?
Oh, I'm out.
That was a lot. That was... My head hurts.
Look who it is.
Who? I don't
know. Ronan Keating.
Don't know who that is.
Life is a roller coaster.
That's this guy?
That's that guy.
Oh, my God, can you take a photo?
Yeah, of course.
I love this guy.
Yeah, he's your favourite guy, isn't he?
Yeah.
Oh, look at you hanging out with Ronan Keating.
Look at me twerking on Ronan Keating.
Oh, my God. Jedward.
Oh, look, there they are.
They look exactly the same, don't they? Apart from all of the differences.
They've got really old hands.
Yeah.
Young faces, old hands, like Madonna.
Should we go and make some waxworks of our own?
Is that a thing?
Yeah.
For real?
Visitors can now bring home a unique souvenir from Waxworks Plus.
Hello.
Hey, yeah.
Their own hand, cast in wax.
Can we do that?
Yeah.
Friendship.
Okay, kids.
Francois guides us through the process of immortalization.
Oh, it's hot!
Step by painful step.
This is your full-time job?
No, not at all. I'm an internship here.
Oh, this is your side hustle.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, man.
Okay, good guys, can go back in the water now.
Oh, that paper cut's not happy.
Bye, Moan.
As soon as
you... No.
Stay there.
Joe, don't leave me.
Bye. That is so weird.
Ow!
Francois!
Ready? Ready?
No, I'm not ready! Look there at my go. Hair! I've got a bowl patch. What do I do about this wax?
Do you want me to take it off?
No!
What colour would you like?
Well, we don't want anything gay, do we?
No, no, no. We're just two straight lads holding hands. Nothing queer here.
Pink, then.
Pink, please.
Yeah, pink.
Ooh, that's pleasing, isn't it?
What about blood?
Like a blood colour. Blood red.
Do us a Lady Macbeth.
That's nice.
Mm. Lovely.
How would you rate this?
Do you think this is very beautiful?
Not that bad, actually.
It sounds like a comedy critic for The Times.
Still bitter?
Still bitter.
And so there's your hands, guys.
Wow. Oh,
that's lovely, look isn't at that nice? Thank you.
Thanks, Francois.
Thank you, guys. Bye.
Don't be doing no willy-nilly dipping.
Our allotted hours are at an end, so all that remains is to cast our votes on Dublin and its many attractions. To swap notes, we head to a home base with booze.
Hi.
Hello, how are you?
We are thirsty.
Thirsty?
And it can only be quenched with 2 pints of stout.
No problem at all.
Look where we are.
That's a funny place, isn't it?
We're in both a bar and a hardware store.
Oh, so I can get my margarita and my hammer.
Exactly that. You know, on the lash, you think, oh, do you know what? I didn't get my galvanised staples.
I actually do need weed killer. I actually will get this.
No problem at all.
I'd like 2 Guinnesses and a 5-ton lashing strap, please.
2 pints, a ratchet strap and some weed killer round out an on-screen spend of £210.60.
Cheers, Joe. Cheers to
Cheers
wood glue.
To wood glue. Mmm. Oh, that's a good pour.
Oh, that's a good pour. What a weekend.
Oh, we've had a fabulous 48 hours, haven't we? We met Ronan Keating, laid down a track that's now going to be released globally.
We're international superstars.
We're international superstars. How did you find Assassination Custard?
That might have been my highlight, actually. Who'd have thought? Just a simple round table and good company.
Yeah, and loads of vermouth.
Mmm.
Really helps. We've done a lot of drinking, and that's very un-Irish, I would say. They're a teetotal gang.
Oh, yeah.
Mawan, would you come back to Dublin?
I'd come back to Dublin. I'd come back for the library.
Mmm.
I'd come back for you, Joe.
Would you go to Blackpool? Because that's the Irish Celtic for Dublin.
Does that mean Blackpool's called Dublin? No.
Oh, my
word. Does Blackpool mean Dublin?
I've lost my mind. Where are we?
Is
what's
it
in
strong?
This? It's very strong. Very strong.
Got any vermouth?
Next time, a gorgeous getaway in Salzburg with Roisin Conaty.
I'm pretty full on.